Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up bank and credit card accounts and download transactions in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Most of the purchases that you make for your business are either deducted from your bank account or charged on a business credit card. Therefore, to ensure that every transaction has been included in your financial statements, you should set up all business bank and credit card accounts with an automatic bank feed that will import your bank and credit card transactions into Xero. By setting up an automatic feed, it will save you time that you would have spent manually entering transactions from your bank and credit card statement into Xero. In this lesson, we will discuss how to set up and import bank and credit card transactions in Xero. First, let's discuss the three ways that you can import bank and credit card transactions into Xero. The first way is called direct feeds. Direct feeds allow you to automatically download bank and credit card transactions into Xero from your bank or financial institution. There are three banks that support direct feeds: City National Bank, Silicon Valley Bank, and Wells Fargo. If you use one of these three banks, then you can head over to the direct feed section for step-by-step instructions on how to set up a bank feed. If you don't bank with one of these three financial institutions that we just discussed, you will use a third party called Yodlee to download your bank or credit card transactions. Yodlee integrates seamlessly with Xero to connect to thousands of online banking websites and financial institutions worldwide. Most small and larger financial institutions allow Yodlee bank feeds. Please note, while Xero does not charge to set up these type of feeds, your bank or financial institution may charge you a fee for this service. Despite the fact that they are a third-party service, setting up a Yodlee feed is just as easy as setting up a direct feed in Xero. We will walk through the steps on how to do this in a few minutes. Like direct feeds, Yodlee feeds will update your bank transactions at least once per day. The third way is to import a bank or credit card statement. If you are not able to set up a direct feed or a Yodlee feed for your bank or credit card account, then you can import your monthly bank or credit card statements into Xero from a file. In order to do this, you will need to request an electronic copy of your bank or credit card statement in one of the following formats: OFX, QBO, QFX, QIF, or CSV. The formats that work best are the first three: OFX, QBO, and QFX. The only users that can add a bank or credit card account are the standard user and the advisor. To learn more about user permissions, check out our How to Invite a User lesson for more details. You can click here to access this lesson. Let's go ahead and walk through the steps on how to set up a direct feed in Xero. From the Accounts menu, we'll go ahead and select Bank Accounts. And let's scroll down and go ahead and click the Add Bank Account button. And we'll go ahead and type the name of our bank here in the search box. So please note that your bank may be listed several times, so you want to make sure that you select the correct one. You'll also notice that you may have the bank listed, and then you'll have maybe the credit card listed if that's an option. So we'll go ahead and select this bank here. Click the blue Login and Connect Accounts to go ahead and connect to your bank's website. Once you see the login screen for your bank or financial institution, go ahead and enter your login ID and password that you normally use to sign on to online banking, and then click the Sign On button. In the next screen, you will see a list of bank accounts that are available for a direct feed. You can select the accounts individually or select all accounts, as this is automatically defaulted to here. There's a note down here also that says, please connect any newly opened or newly eligible accounts automatically with Xero Online Accounting. Note that this option is automatically selected. If this is not something that you want to do, you want to go ahead and remove that check mark. Once you have the bank account that you'd like to connect selected, go ahead and click Continue. In the next screen here, we've got the account that we selected that we want to go ahead and connect with a direct feed. We must accept the terms and conditions and then go ahead and click the Connect My Accounts button once more. After you have set them up, your bank and credit card accounts will appear on the Xero dashboard so that you can easily keep an eye on them. Similar to direct feeds, the steps for setting up a Yodlee feed for a bank or credit card account are identical. So we'll go back to Accounts and select Bank Accounts. We'll go ahead and click on Add Bank Account here. And then we want to type the name of our bank in the search field as we did before. And then again, just be aware that you'll have various versions of your bank come up, so you want to make sure you select the correct one. So we'll select this one. In this screen, you will need to enter the account name, the account number, and the currency that you want to track this account in. For account name, enter the name that you would like to use to track this account in Xero. Please note, if you have more than one business checking account, be sure to use the name of the account and maybe the last four digits of the account number as the account name, as we have done here. The account number field should include the full account number. Please do not include any slashes or dashes in this field. Currency field. Select the currency that you would like to use to track the bank or credit card activity. One of the many benefits of using Xero is that it has a robust multi-currency feature that allows you to track foreign bank and credit card accounts. Check out our multi-currency lesson to learn more about how this works. You can click here to access this lesson. Once you've completed all the fields, go ahead and click Continue. And in the next screen, you will need to have available your user ID and password that you normally would use to log into your account online. And go ahead and complete that information in this screen. Once you have completed the user ID and passcode, go ahead and make sure you accept the terms and conditions and then click Next. So notice we have a notification here that it's connecting to our bank account. It can take several minutes, it says, to connect. This process can actually take up to 1 hour. So you can always leave this page and you'll be notified within your Xero inbox here when the connection has completed. All right, so once the connection is completed, basically you can actually select the account that you'd like to go ahead and set up the import for. So there could be one account there as we have, or maybe multiple accounts, so you want to select those. In the import transaction section here, from the dropdown, we want to go ahead and select the start date that you would like to begin downloading transactions from. Please note that this will be determined by how far back your bank or credit card company will allow you to go back and download transactions. If you select all available transactions, Xero will download up to 3 months worth of transactions here. Cancel activation allows you to cancel bank feeds at any time for any bank or credit card account. Once you've made your selections, you can go ahead and click OK. And then you should see this message that lets you know that the bank feed for the bank account has been activated. And it says it may take a few minutes for your transactions to appear in Xero. After you have set up your bank and credit card accounts, they will appear here on the Xero dashboard so that you can easily keep an eye on them. Please note, click the link below for troubleshooting tips on how to refresh a feed if it crashes. So if for some reason your transactions don't start coming through or they stop, you will need to refresh the feed. So check out those troubleshooting tips for help with that. Now let's talk about how to import a bank or credit card statement. To import a bank or credit card statement, the first thing that you need to do is download an OFX, QBO, or QFX bank or credit card statement from your financial institution's website. If none of these formats are available, click the link below to learn how to download a CSV file. Here are a few tips to keep in mind when downloading a bank or credit card statement. Tip number one, include the file extension when you save the file. For example, if you are downloading the January statement, you can put something like January2017.OFX to represent the file type. Tip number two, if you have multiple bank or credit card accounts, be sure to download a monthly statement for each account separately. So each account needs to have its own separate file, each bank account. Tip number three, if you are downloading an OFX, QBO, or QFX file, which is one of the recommended file types, there are no modifications needed to the file. Simply save it, and then you want to proceed to import it directly into Xero. If your file contains more than 1,000 transactions, you will have to split up the file into two. So you cannot import more than 1,000 transactions at a time. All right, let's go ahead and walk through the steps on how to import that data into Xero. So we'll go to Accounts and Bank Accounts. On the right here, you want to click on the Manage Account button and select Import a Statement. In this screen, you want to go ahead and browse and locate the bank statement that you saved to your computer that you want to import. Once you've selected your file, it should appear to the right here of the Browse button. Go ahead and click the Import button to proceed with the import. If you need to make changes to a bank or credit card account, you can do that from the Bank Account screen or from the Chart of Accounts. In this lesson, we will show you how to edit a bank account from the Bank Account screen. So go back to, if you aren't on your Bank Account screen here, go ahead and go back to Accounts and then Bank Accounts. And once you get to this screen, we want to go ahead and click on the Manage Account button again and then select Edit Account Details. In this screen, you can edit the account name field here. This is how it appears in Xero. You can also edit the account number here. So once you have made the changes, you want to make sure and save your work. If you close a bank or credit card account, you can delete it in Xero if you have never posted any transactions to it. However, if you have posted transactions to a bank or credit card account, then you will not be able to delete it because of the impact it will have on your financial statements. Instead, you can archive an account that you no longer plan to use. This will remove the account from the chart of accounts list and any account dropdown while working in Xero. However, it will still appear on financial statement reports. Later on, if you decide to use the account again, you can easily restore or unarchive an account that was previously archived. For step-by-step instructions on how to delete, archive, or restore a bank or credit card account, watch our How to Set Up a Chart of Accounts lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. That wraps up the lesson on how to set up bank and credit card accounts and download transactions in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.